Rachida, 27 years old. I was born in The Hague. I'm currently living in The Hague, and my dad was Moroccan. My mother is Dutch. Like, I'm pretty sure I had ADHD. Like, I was always running around being crazy. I played soccer from a really early age on a pretty high level, like in the national team. And that progressed into skating, and that progressed into snowboarding. So I was just basically always doing something. Currently, what I'm doing is I'm working in a snowboard shop. It's located in Snowboard-Sudemir. I work at dive stands, so I'm selling boards, I'm selling boots, kind of everything. Next to that, I'm also teaching in the dome, and I'm teaching for Team Extreme. It's a group me and a friend kind of built up, and we're like basically coaching kids and making sure they have a way to navigate towards the freestyle snowboarding. And yeah, it's really cool to see those kids grow up and progress within the scene. So I'm really blessed to be able to do that. Well, I was already skating back in the day, so I was already very affectionate with extreme sports. And I remember a friend of mine, Anthony, he started snowboarding, and he was just like, you know, you should join, it's really, really fun. So I just joined him into the dome, and I remember, like, from the first moment, like, I strapped in, I basically never strapped out anymore and just continued to ride almost every single day with him. We have a couple of domes here in the Netherlands. I think the groundbreaking dome is really like Snowworld. They're expanding as well. For me, the best dome is in Sudemir. And I think because it's open 24/7, the conditions don't really change. Like, it's always the same cold. It's like always the same setting. And within a day, like from 9 a.m. till 11 p.m., you can just make so many laps that I think that's really, really what makes indoor dome riders really good at rail riding, also because the fact we don't have a lot of kickers, so you basically don't really focus on that. You just go out, you ride rails with your friends from morning till midnight, and yeah, I think that's really the difference between people that ride the mountain and people that ride dome. Same settings, long times that you're able to ride, and yeah, I think that's where our progression comes from. I think my peers within snowboarding, now that I'm getting older, are progressing more into getting injured, especially having been injured for like two to three years. It really like resets a button in your head, like, okay, you know, you're also vulnerable, you're also able to like break things, to have surgery. So especially when you get older, you have work, you have responsibilities, that slowly creeps more in the front of your mind. And I don't know, I think my assets within snowboarding are the fact that I'm able to do it almost every single day, be on my board. And that, of course, I work next to it, but I always make sure that, like, I work for a company that understands what I do, and that makes it really easy for me to travel around and make sure I'm staying on my board. I had a part in Postland a couple of years ago, and the year after I had a part in Too Hard with the American girls. Shooting mostly happens in like small groups, because of course when you're together with 15 riders on one spot, it doesn't really work out. So mostly you go like in groups or 3 to 5, and you just go together to a spot, you build it up, and yeah, you start riding it. For this year, I haven't filmed. I actually don't have a lot of plans of filming. After I injured my knee, like, snowboarding sort of slowly faded to the background. I'm just doing competitions, having fun, which is, of course, a big part of why I snowboard. And I feel that filming parts, although it's really, really fun, it also puts a lot of stress on you to be able to have a full part at the end of the season. So for me, I'm not going to be able to do something probably this year. And yeah, the Postland group has always been like my favorite group. You have Sace, you have Tim, you have Cas, you have Max. Like, it's such an amazing vibe within that group, and there's such an amazing bond and friendship. It's almost like a little family, which makes it so much fun to just go out and like shoot on the streets. It's really, really awesome. I think between urban riders and slopestyle riders, it's been a bit divided. Of course, when you're a slopestyle rider, most of them get involved with national teams, and when you're in a national team, you have certain rules you have to keep on. Like, you sort of have to live healthy, you can't smoke, you're not really like able to go out and party a lot. So I think that sort of divides it. Wherein also, I've always felt there's a more competitive, like a competitive feel with slopestyle snowboarding, and I feel that whenever I go to a rail battle with the girls, with the boys, it just doesn't matter. We're all sort of a family. We don't care. Of course, you kind of care, like you want to win, but I'm like, if someone else wins and she deserves it and she rode like insane, I'm gonna be super happy for that. And I feel like that's something that's sometimes missing a little bit within like slopestyle snowboarding. Like, it's, I need to win. And I think Rockarail started out as like, I think, pretty smallish. Like, we had a big riders, but most of them were from the Netherlands. And somehow it just got picked up by the snowboard scene as like one of the sickest rail contests there is, even though that in the past there hasn't always been a lot of prize money. Riders still came up because the setup was just so fucking gnarly. And I think what keeps Rockarail going is, again, like that family bond. Everyone that comes there is friends, we know each other. We go out riding the domes a week before, and everyone's just so happy to see each other. So I think that atmosphere is a big part of why Rockarail's been going for as long as it's been going. And for me, I'm just blessed because, of course, it's in my hometown. I know like 90% of the people that's in the crowd, which makes it super fun to be up there and to see in the crowd and like hear everyone cheering your name. And like to take a win on top of that, or to take a podium on top of that, is just like a massive, massive blessing with your entire like friends and family in the crowd. So yeah, work real, so clear to stay. Yeah, I think a big part of why this type of snowboarding sort of went away is because there was kind of a generation gap. I felt like the kids that got into snowboarding were more about going, they weren't really snowboarders, they went on snowboarding, but they weren't like breathing, living and like searching for it every day. And nowadays you see that slowly changing anymore, or you see it slowly changing. The generation after is right now that's coming up is stoked and they want to snowboard and they breed it, they watch movies. And I think that's why you're also seeing like a lot of contests coming back again, which is really, really cool, because we used to have so many of these like outdoor setups and stuff, whereas now you only have like one or two right here in the Netherlands then. If Rockarail will be made into a tour, it's kind of taking it to the next level. It's probably gonna be hard to keep that friendly vibe and the fun of it, because of course when you get in the tour, you get more sponsors involved, there's more money involved. So I think that's gonna be really challenging. But as Rockarail is an event itself, I think it's definitely ready to like go to different countries, go to different cities and just travel around and like ride. It would be really, really cool. For me, snowboarding always has been more about style than tricks. I would rather do like a really, really stylish, easy trick than that I'll do like the most hardest trick and just barely make it. So for me, it's more about style than doing the sickest trick, for sure.